enough. That's how it's done.
Looks like we got a job to do, yeah?
If anything should happen in the water, we're relying on you three. If it gets dangerous, pull out quick.
Right.
Be careful, okay?
So, how shall we do this?
Thank you.
I foresee no difficulty.
We'll be right back. Wait. Thank you.
Well then, what next?
So be it.
Farewell.
No time to waste. Let's go. Soon. She has sent fiends to test our summoner's strength.
Who is she?
Unalesca.
Lady Unalesca!
In Xanarkand, she awaits the arrival of the strongest.
She is still alive?
As much as Micah and Seymour.
I see.
Lost your nerve?
No. Nothing frightens me now.
Braska would be proud.
Then I must not let him down.
Wait.
How many stakes you think we can get out of these?
It comes!
We'll be right back. Can't we rest a little?
No need. We reach the summit soon.
I know. That's why I want to stop for a bit. Soon means that there's not much time left.
Riku.
Fine. I'll think on the way.
Hey, come on, let's go.
We are. Almost there, aren't we?
We've come a long way.
What's so funny?
You remind me of myself. Hmm? Before, the closer I came to Xanarkan, the more I wondered. When we arrive, Braska will call the final Aeon. He will fight Sin, then die. I thought my mind was made up long before. But when I stood here, my resolve wavered.
Never would have figured. Legendary guardians choke sometimes too, yeah?
Legendary guardian. I was just a boy. A boy about your age, actually. I wanted to change the world too. But I changed nothing. That is my story.
Dead for 1,000 years. A city I had to see with my own eyes. The end of Yuna's journey. The last chapter in my story. My thoughts, they kept floating up and then slipping through my fingers. Slipping away before I could pin them down with words.
Yuna, I say no. If we go down there, then you'll...
Riku. You're a true friend, and I thank you, but I must go down to Xanarkand.
I'm not saying we shouldn't go, but shouldn't we think about it some more? There's gotta be some kind of way we can save you, Yuna!
All my life, I knew this moment would come.
Yuni!
Thank you, Riku. Thank you for everything.
Don't say that, Yuni. It's not over yet.
Tell Sid, thank you.
No, you can tell him yourself. Say that because we're gonna see each other again, okay?
Kimari, let's go. Sir Oren, Kimari told me, when my father wanted me taken from Bavel to Besaid, it was you who told Kimari, right? I had always wanted to meet you someday. I am truly glad that I had that chance. Having you as a guardian was so great an honor. I don't know how to thank you. Perhaps if I defeat Sin, that will be my thanks to you. That's what I'll do. Yes, I will challenge Sin. I will defeat Sin. If you are all there watching this, then I guess Sin is already gone. And so am I. I suppose. Anyway, I just wanted to say, Sir Oren, I thank you. Kimari, do you remember the first day we met? I was only 7. My father had defeated Sin, and all Bavel was celebrating. Everyone was saying what a hero my father was. I was so happy. But when night came, it occurred to me. My father had defeated Sin, and now he was dead. Now I was all alone. I couldn't sleep. So I wandered into the town, away from the celebrating crowds. I stood on the bridge in Bavel, where my father and I had parted. Standing there, alone, I could see the fields where he had fought Sin. Then, you appeared, Kimari. You said you were looking for the daughter of Braska, remember? At first, I was so scared, until I realized what a gentle person you are. You weren't used to talking to children. When I told you that I was Braska's daughter, you said you would take me as far from Bavel as you could. That it was the wish of a man facing death. I think I cried then, because that was when I knew my father was dead, and I would never see him again. You just held me without saying a word. I cried after we got to Besaid, too. When you tried to go, after leaving me in the care of the temple, I held on to you crying, "Don't go, don't go." And you listened, Kimari. You stayed. Kimari, thank you. Thank you so much. And I've always liked your broken horn. Waka, Lulu. I'll never forget my days spent with you, growing up in Besaid. We always played together, us and Chapu. That's why I was always so happy, I think. And when you refused to let me become a summoner, and I did it anyway, I'm sorry. I've always wanted to apologize. You know, when you tried to stop me then, really, I was happy. I could tell you really cared about me. You were like my big brother and sister. No, I think you really were my big brother and sister. What else? I love watching you play blitzball, Waka. I even love it when you scold me, Lulu. Really? I guess that leaves the newest guardian, star player of the Xanarkand Abes. You are. I am. Well, I'm glad. I'm glad that we met. We haven't even known each other that long, but it's funny. So this is what it feels like. It's a much more wonderful feeling than anything I had ever imagined. Wonderful. But it hurts sometimes. I wonder. I just want to say thank you for everything. Maybe that's why it hurts. When I think about us never being together again at all, I'm afraid. No, I shouldn't say that. I'll do that part over.
What you up to?
Listen to my story. This may be our last chance. There was more, right? I mean, like that time. Anyone?
I think...
Yes?
I think that we should stop. Maybe. For now.
Let's go.